being able to interpret the signs of the times rightly. When you talk about the signs of the times, there are many signs, yes, but is it the sign that comes from God? Or is it simply our own interpretations of the sign, our own standards? Important, therefore, that the gospel must be relevant today. Not yesterday, but today, and apply the will of God for today. In fact, if you have to look at the many signs that are around us, or even within us, simple could say there are two laws that are happening within ourselves. The law of the flesh and the law of the spirit. And this is the spiritual combat, many spiritual writers would say, happening within ourselves. When we look into our own lives, we realize that we are both children of Adam and Eve, wounded with sin, and sometimes, as we say, prone to sin. But we are also children of God. But yet, because of this wound that happens within us, there is this pull between what is good for me and what is good for God. And we hear a lot of times when young people would say, "Father, alam mo, gusto kong kumain, pero hindi kumagawa. Gusto kong kumain, pero hindi kumagawa." Exactly why we have many repeated predominant sins paulit-ulit na lang. Habang masabi natin parang, how can I get out from this? Well, we are not alone in this struggle. Even St. Paul here in the first reading, we realize that you say, we will not have enough strength to overcome sin. But if through the finger of God and through the power of God, that we allow ourselves simply to be caught up in this struggle of God, then doing the will of God is knowing the precepts of the Lord. There is also a psalm that says, "Teach me your statutes. Lord, teach me your laws. The law of God that is within us. And the law that allows us to have justice coupled with charity and mercy." Justice coupled with charity and mercy. And that is why in that second part of the gospel tells us, important as that interpret the laws, important is relationship. So that if you are able to reconcile with your brother, you do not have to go to the court. That brother, just approach your brother and try to reconcile along the way. Otherwise, sometimes if we have our own standards, ito good sa akin, sa naman good sa akin yan, we have a class. Oftentimes I hear from the discussions even in the internet blog, merong pastor talking with a atheist. The atheist say, "There is no God." So if there is no God, what is your standard of knowing what is good and bad? And someone will say, "As long as it's good for me, then you know it." But it is relative. What is good for me and good for the other one. for me, I can have your cell phone. Can I have your backpack? Akin na yan, it's good for me. But no, everyone has a sense of conscience that tells us what is good and what is bad. As the Lord would say, deep within your being, I will plant my law, I will write it in your heart. And truly, as we are conscious about this conscience of which God is embedded, this silent voice of the Lord within us, then we can truly say, if God is with me, then we are able to decipher, to discern what is good and what is bad. Even St. John would say, try to discern the good from the evil spirits. The good spirit is always, the fruits of the spirit are good. It is justice, fortitude, love and mercy and many others that provides us harmony in life. Anything that is bad destroys, separates, and also falls, makes us a troubles in our lives. So once again, as we say to the Lord,